5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
Years ago, the world witnessed an unprecedented milestone, an impossible achievement, the manifestation of human curiosity, technology, and sheer force of will. Neil Armstrong stepped onto the surface of the moon in an event broadcast live to over 500 million people. A small camera, strapped upside down to the Apollo 11 lunar module, transmitted this incredible moment to Earth in stark black and white at 10 frames per second. The 7-pound Westinghouse SSTV space camera was a technological feat, but there was a problem. The space camera couldn't broadcast in the right resolution or frame rate for television. So in order to show the world this momentous occasion, engineers at NASA tracking stations took the lunar signal, displayed it on a 10-inch video monitor, and used TV cameras to literally film the monitor. This recording, with different contrast, brightness, and resolution, was broadcast worldwide. However, the original, raw, high-resolution stream was also recorded onto 1-inch telemetry tapes as a backup. Those historically valuable tapes were stored away until the early 1980s, which is when NASA completely lost track of them. That's right, NASA lost the original recordings of the Apollo 11 moon landing. Well, maybe lost isn't quite the right word. The original tapes were most likely reused or overwritten with low-resolution satellite imagery for the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, because they were running out of tapes. Gone. Seemingly forever.
Houston, Columbia on the high gate, over.
Columbia, this is Houston reading you loud and clear, over.
This is Houston reading.
But that's not the end of the story. In 2006, NASA announced they were going to try to track down any original high-resolution copies. The search team was headed by Richard Nafsger, a former NASA engineer who oversaw the original Apollo 11 broadcast, along with Stan LaBar, the man who designed the original Westinghouse lunar camera, and other key figures involved in the 1969 broadcast. In an article by Wired, the team described the process of hunting through 4 million boxes at the Washington National Records Center. These records are not organized, not digitized, and not efficiently cataloged. Thousands of boxes were destroyed by a sprinkler system. 140,000 tapes from the Apollo era were checked out and never returned. Some of the places that they were sent had their contents destroyed, erased, or simply degraded through bad storage.
The records clearly showed that there's an inescapable conclusion that this team has reached, and that is that these 45 tapes were included in the several hundred thousand that were pulled out, recertified, degaussed, and put back into the network. The slow scan recordings are no longer.
Yes, the original lost Apollo 11 tapes are most likely overwritten with outdated satellite imagery. But that didn't mean they came up with nothing. Their search resulted in unmuddied, high-resolution copies from the original broadcast recordings. For the first time in decades, new, high-resolution images and video were available to the public, never before seen quite like this.
As one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.